Hello, and welcome to Storm Drum 3 by East West. I'm David Earle, and I'll be your host as we explore the wider world of drums, from the ethnic to the weird. Storm Drum 3 is the brainchild of Nick Phoenix and Doug Rogers. It's a follow-up to the phenomenally popular Storm Drum 2. It differentiates itself by giving us a library full of stunning, high-quality production that actually stretches the technical abilities of the modern recording studio. The library includes drums that were not only recorded individually, but they were recorded in groups, recorded being played by professional percussionists, and recorded some of them with up to 5 sets of microphones going at the same time that can be mixed together in the play engine. Now, Storm Drum 3 actually takes full advantage of the newest incarnation of the play engine, pushing its capabilities to the limit. Nick Phoenix is a percussion-obsessed individual, and he is a Grateful Dead fan. For this project, East West was actually able to get Mickey Hart with his amazingly eclectic array of drums. And they also teamed up with Remo to get some really interesting custom-made drums. They have Mickey Hart advising everybody as well. He's in on the production, as well as talking with the players, as well as playing himself. There are actual loops from Mickey Hart in this library. Along with Mickey Hart, Nick was able to wrangle other great players as well. They've got Chili Eduardo and Greg Ellis playing, and you know they're giving the kind of care and attention that only a seasoned percussionist veteran can provide. Storm Drum 3 is remarkably well-programmed. It's a special well of inspiration for me. There's over 87 gigabytes of 24-bit, 44.1K samples included in this massive undertaking. So let's explore and have some fun in this percussion candy land. Okay, so first things first, I'm going to jump over to the browser. And let's just talk about these folders for a second. We've got a quick start folder. This is kind of like the vetted best of this instrument. You can go through all of these and really check out all of the different types of sounds that you're going to have available to you in Storm Drum 3. They are really wonderful, and I put a couple of them over here in Logic so that we can have a listen to them in a little bit. Underneath the quick start folder, we have big drums. These are drums that are just very large. We have gongs, clocks, and waterphones. These are really neat. We have some very unique gongs, Mongolian gongs, Wuhan gongs, Turkish epic cymbals. Those are pretty amazing. Then we have a grandfather clock that was recorded and sampled so that you can use it as a percussion instrument. Really creative and neat. Some of the best waterphone samples I've ever heard. So the waterphone is actually a bowl of water that has spikes coming out of it that you can bow and tap like a percussion instrument if you like. Very, very prominent in horror and sci-fi movies. And it's very hard to record, and they did a great job. So that's gongs, clocks, and waterphones. We have metals, shakers, small drums, taiko, woods, and then we have live loops. So these are actual giant libraries of loops that were put together with the East West team and Mickey Hart, and they actually time to your DAW. So your DAW's tempo will drive these loops. Very, very cool stuff. Now, I want to play this Daiko on the left-hand side here. Now you can hear a lot of space on that drum. And if you want to, you can go into your mixer and we can start processing it a bit. So I do have a little bit of processing already. I've got some reverb. I've got a SSL channel strip going on here. This is all included with Play 5. And then I have a bus compressor on the right-hand side. But what's very special now is if I close this, we have these 5 channel strips that are the different mics that are being used to record this instrument. See these faders right here? If you click on them, any instrument that has these, you'll be able to switch between these different sets of stereo microphones. So let's check it out if I listen to just the close mics. Now let's listen to the mid. Main. Hi-fi. and ribbon microphones. Really different senses of space. And when you get something that's very transient, like this balafone, let's try a mix without close mics. Now, each one of these channels has its own effects processing. You can go in here and you have a SSL channel strip for every single one, which is pretty awesome. And then on your master output, you have processing as well. So that's pretty cool. So, because you might go into one of these and even though it's very well recorded, what was I hearing? Maybe it was the ribbon mics. No, I think it was the hi-fi. Yeah, I'm hearing a little bit of low end. It's just coming from the mic pickup. So go in here, turn on my SSL channel strip, put on a low cut. Add a little compression. Pretty cool stuff. So there are a lot of instruments that have this capability, and you should definitely check them out. So in the player here, we have delay, we have reverb, we have an envelope. This is an amplitude envelope. We have sensitivity, so this is going to be your velocity curve. You can change that so that the keyboard that you're playing will, or, you know, MIDI percussion instrument or whatever, will react in a different way. You can make it more or less sensitive depending on how it's reacting. We have a filter. And then we have something called tuning. So what's interesting about the tuning switch here, in some of these instruments, we have loops and things like that, and we have tonal stuff that we can actually tune now. There's a difference between tuning A and tuning B. What's going on is tuning A is a standard tuning where things will speed up and slow down depending on how high or low you tune them. If you go to tuning B, it will actually keep the timing intact while allowing you to tune. When you use Tune B, we have a normal setting and a high quality setting. If you've got a beefy computer, you'll be able to use the high setting. It just is a better stretching algorithm. But you need to have a CPU that's able to do that kind of processing. So that's basically the mixer and the player. Let's get into some of these sounds. Let's check them out. So we heard the balafone. What I love, we have these weird instruments in Storm Drum 3, like the brass kettle. Check this sound out. Literally a brass kettle that's being played like a percussion instrument. We have a cajon, which is a box drum. Now, that's not my beautiful playing. That's actually a loop that's incorporated with this library. So if we wanted to, so you can hear that he's speeding up and slowing down when I do that tuning, right? So now with tuning B, he stays in time. So I just wanted to show you that as an example of how that works. The Beast, this is the largest tom ever made. It's by Remo. That, again, when you get in here and you get into mixing these mics together, you're going to have a lot of fun. Dragon Ensemble. So this is calling back to the Storm Drum 2 library where you have these gigantic cinematic hits. So you can put that in on your big cinematic trailer. So here I've got the Boule Custom, one of the drums that I'm unfamiliar with. I saw it next to a Zydeco instrument, so maybe it's part of Zydeco. But what's great is they give you these rhythms that you can kind of use as a reference. So it's got kind of a swinging rhythm, and you can build your own rhythm off of that. You can kind of use that as a guide for how it should be played, because the percussionists that are playing these instruments are intimately acquainted with these instruments. Now we can also tune it. Go to my tuning B. All rhythm stays intact. Beautiful double ceramic drum. Another one of my favorite cinematic ones is the Lord of Toms. Again, we have that Storm Drum true massiveness, but we also have these really intimate drums. Like, check out the attack on these Surdos. You can just feel it in your teeth. Now, remember when I was talking about waterphones? These waterphones were immaculately recorded, and some of the only waterphones that I've ever been able to use that don't grate on me. They use all of the wonderful special qualities of this instrument, but it retains this very balanced tonal character. Awesome. Clockwork. So this is actually a grandfather clock that was recorded, and we can play it as a percussion instrument. It's just so creative. It's awesome that these guys, beyond making really perfectly made instruments, they also get these funky, interesting, eclectic instruments as well. Now, when we get down here, we're getting into the Mickey Hart loops. We've got this one called 6 Minutes in Tibet. So check it out. I'm just holding 3 keys down, and it's matching the tempo of my song. So you can see how many keys here are white. Each one of those has a rhythm on it. And you can mix and match them together. They match your DAW, and you get this just amazingly well-played, perfect loops from master musicians. What I also love about them is the loops are long. They're not just these short little 2-bar phrases. They're very long and fully thought out percussion lines that just breathe really, really well. So I highly recommend just jumping into this instrument and going through everything that it has. I think it's one of the greatest percussion libraries out there right now. It's really, truly amazing. You have all of the flexibility that the Play Engine gives you, with the addition of those extra mics in the mixer that you can play around with. You have these live loops that were recorded by Mickey Hart and crew, and there's just nothing like it. I really think you're going to enjoy this library. So I'm going to leave you with this demo of Storm Drum 3 so you can really hear what it's capable of, and I'll see you in our next cartoon. Ciao.